Okay, good morning. My name is Dr. Vikram Uttam Pandit, and we gather here for learning the chemistry. Some very basic part, or I can say introduction to the organic chemistry, inorganic chemistry, and physical chemistry. So at very beginning, I just want to share one thought with you, is that you all know Aishwarya Rai, now the Aishwarya Rai Bachchan. So when she was asked in one of the interview, when you will leave this world, that time what you will give to the all the people, all the world. So she gave a very fantastic answer to that question, that when she will leave this world, she will give her eyes to the needy person, so that she will able to see the whole world again with those eyes, right? So basically what I'm trying to say to you is that when you are learning to the science, or basically the chemistry, it's an opportunity for you to give something to this society or whole world. Okay, on this note, I want to start some introductory part to our general subject, that is chemistry. And in the chemistry, the syllabus, I think the syllabus is already with you. Let me share the screen first. I will show you. Yeah, video might not be visible to you because I am going to start the presentation over here. Okay, just let me know whether it is visible to you now or not. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, so in introduction to chemistry, we are going to start some chapters, or just introductory part to the chemistry. My name is Dr. Vikram Uttam Pandit, and I am master in organic chemistry. I have qualified CSIR NET, UGC NET, GATE exam. Also, I have completed my PhD in material science. And currently, I am working as an assistant professor and PG coordinator at Haribhai Vidyasai College, Pune. So this is very simple, and I just want to elaborate and make chemistry sophisticated. You just pay attention. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in between, or there is a chat box. You can just put your queries in chat box. For today's lecture, I am going to show you 2-3 slides only. Then on this PowerPoint presentation only, I am going to draw various structures, and then I am also going to record this video, so that sir will provide this recording to you. Whenever it is possible, you can watch it again and again, and you will better understand all this. So chemistry, basically this chemistry is divided into 3 subcategories. For example, in our syllabus, or in everywhere, these atoms are there, heat, energy, and rate of reactions are there. So this is one kind of chemistry that categorized under the physical chemistry. Then we all know that very basic periodic table, all the atoms are present in the periodic table, which comes under the chemistry. Then the VSEPR theory, for example, the hybridization, all metal, non-metal, and metalloids, they comes under the inorganic part. Most important material from this inorganic is H2O, that is water. And lastly, or thirdly, the most important thing is related to the carbon, the bond between the carbons, the various structures, and the reactions that comes under the category of organic reactions. So in our syllabus also, these 3 things are there, and all syllabus is divided in such a way that physical, inorganic, and organic chemistry can be easily distinguished. So this is the syllabus which is given from the unit 1, 1, 2, unit 4, 5. So in today's lecture, I just want to share few things. So if you have this PDF, just see that atomic structure, then quantum mechanics and electronic configuration. So this part, as far as my knowledge, this part comes under the physical chemistry. Then ionic bonding, covalent bonding, resonating structure and molecular approach, this molecular orbital approach, how molecules are made, this comes under the category of inorganic chemistry. Then molecular approach, this just repeated over here. Next, the physical electronic displacement, structures, reaction intermediates and organic acids. Most importantly, stereochemistry, this comes under the organic chemistry. And second part of this organic chemistry is subdivided here, aliphatic hydrocarbons, alkane, alkene, alkyne. So in Maharashtra board or the state board, I think this whole syllabus is covered in the 12th standard. Okay, so this portion is important in the organic chemistry. This is related to the inorganic chemistry and this is related to the physical chemistry. So from this, today we are going to start with from this 3.3.1 to 3.5. So here, first of all, I will just show you some very basic things so that you will understand these all the topics effectively. For example, first thing here, the physical effect of electronic displacement. For example, various effects are there: inductive effect, resonance effect, hyperconjugation. This what we have to learn. Then in stereochemistry, how the structures are there, what are the organic compounds, what are the carbon. So the basic for this organic chemistry is nothing but a carbon, because any compound which is made up of an organic structure, organic skeleton, is nothing but a carbon. So the first thing is that the carbon, and this carbon, from where this carbon it comes. So this carbon, generally in nature, it is found in earth crust, right? And all the things which we are heating up, those after making a char, that is nothing but coming into again a carbon. Now this carbon, basically it comes from the periodic table, and if you know, this periodic table is very, very important. Now for your standard or for your career, this periodic table plays a very important role. This periodic table starts from hydrogen. So at least from one atomic number of hydrogen is one. So we have to go to here: helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and neon. At least 1 to 10. These atoms are very, very important. So you should understand what is the importance while solving the various inorganic as well as organic problems, as well as this series. This series, these are like periods and these are the groups. So first A group, this hydrogen, lithium, sodium, these are also important, and all this P block. So this is basic, that this is like S block, P block, D block, zero group, and these are like F block elements. This is there in the electronic configuration. At the time of that electronic configuration, we will cover this periodic table. Now, the most important thing, what we want from periodic table in today's lecture, we want that these groups, these atoms which are present over here, as well as some of the atoms which are present over here. How to remember this periodic table? I don't want to force you to learn all this periodic table by heart, but some of the elements you should learn. And very funny and tricks, very simple tricks are available. If you search on this internet, if you put the periodic table, tricks to remember periodic table in the YouTube, that time you will understand how funny or how easy these things are there. For example, see this first A group. In first A group, so many elements are there, like hydrogen, lithium, sodium, no, then potassium. Here also, in this seventh A group, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, So I'll just give the few names. See how Marathi language is being utilized and Hindi language is being utilized for this remembering the periodic table. First group, this is H L E. So they have made the one of the tree that he lina kare rab se faryad. Okay, Helena, their name of the girl, kare rab se faryad. Then second group, like beta mange car, centro bap roe. So all these words are there in, if you search on the YouTube. So these type of tricks are there in the P block. While solving the electronic configuration, that time I will give more and more detail about all this P block. Now just remember, this carbon is having a atomic number 6, and this is the carbon, its atomic number is 6. So as in first topic, there is an atom in the molecule, there is a in the central, there is a this is the center, and around this center there are electrons are present in various shells. For example, first shell is like a K shell, L shell, and this center is known as a nucleus of this atom. Inside the nucleus there are protons and neutrons present. Around these protons and neutrons, electrons are revolving in the different shells, like K shell and L shell. So what is the basic that I am going to tell you about this organic chemistry or this today's lecture, that carbon is having atomic number 6. Its electronic configuration, if you remember from 11th and 12th standard, that its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p2. So the S is like a, the spherical orbitals are there, and P is like a dumbbell shaped orbitals are there. This S is having a capacity of 2 electrons, P is having capacity of 6 electrons, and divided into 3 orbitals. At ground state, what this carbon does, it will put 2 electrons in first 1A shell, 2 electrons in 2S shell. The 2 electrons are remaining, but these 3 orbitals are there. That's why 2 electrons remain in the X and Y, PX and PY. One is remain empty at ground state. So when it goes into the excited state or energy increased, one of the electron from 2s, it goes into 2p. Okay, see, these electrons are also present in K and L shell. But here, this orbital, one of the electron goes here and it will make a 4 unpaired electron. Now what is paired and unpaired? These electrons which are having a single spin, single arrow is showing upward. This is one electron. Okay, electrons which are revolving around the nucleus, one electrons are there. When you want to pair, according to so many rules, like Apoboot's principle, and we have this rule in the again in one of the chapter of inorganic chemistry, that time I will explain why this is having an opposite spin. Okay, so now these are unpaired and these are paired. So here in excited state means here you can make a new bond. So in excited state, how many electrons are present? 4 electrons are present. That means carbon is having a 4 electrons available for making a bond. So that's why the valency of carbon is 4. Valency means it is a combining capacity of that particular atom. Now in combining capacity, if carbon is having a 4 valency, that means it can make 4 bonds. So that's why again and again we can say that carbon's valency is 4, so it will make a 4 bonds. This is very important. If you remember that carbon's valency is 4, and you, what is your role? That you have to keep it 4 only. If you make it 3, it is not correct structure. If you make it 5, then also it is not correct structure. Okay, and we are going to draw a few structures based on this valency. Okay, so this much presentation I just want to show you, because carbon's valency is very important here. Now in this carbon's valence, what I told you that carbon, any carbon, it can make only how many bond? 4 bonds. Now in the 12th standard, we have alkane, alkene, alkyne. So alkane will make one bond, and when there is alkene, see what is this structure is making. I will just draw again this same. This is the alkane, right? This is the one of the alkane part. Now if I draw alkene, carbon, and alkene means double bond. Now if I made two bond over here, what is there in this first structure? There are 4 bonds, so carbon's valence is satisfied. This is correct structure. But here what will happen? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now there are like 5 bonds are there, so this is not correct, right? So for that purpose, what you have to do, you have to remove one of the bond over here, then only the valency of carbon is same. Again, this is alkane, this is alkene. In case of alkyne, again, in case of alkyne, if you are going to put triple bond, okay, see, valency will become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So again, it is not clear. So what you have to do, you have to remove this as well as you have to remove this. Only one bond and triple bond. So it will change or it will correct the valency of given alkyne. So what type of questions will ask in the question paper of Pune University? They will give you the name of the structure and you have to write the correct structure for this. So this is important. Okay, for example, in this question paper, if they ask you 2-methyl propane, okay, so propane, p-a-n-e, 2-propane, okay, and now what will happen? 2-methyl, you know, methyl, first group from the alkane family, CH4. Now as you are increasing the carbon, it is changing, okay, and this alkane, alkene, alkyne, in 12th standard you already have this type of formula, CnH2n+2, right? So this is the general formula for alkane. So we are not going to detail about the alkene and alkyne. Now to just read this type of a basic things, okay. So when you put the value of carbon over here, like if it is a 0, everything will be 0, so no need to write any structure. But we have one carbon, so put n's value as 1, so this structure will become 2 ones are 2 plus 2 4, so we'll get first candidate, that is methane. When you put the value of n is 2, so 2 to the 4 plus 2, it will become 6. So C2H6, right? So this is the ethane, methane, ethane, and third one it will be the propane, then butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, and so on. So this is again a very, very basic, but you have to at least read about this. Now what we have to write, draw the structure of 2-methyl propane. So while drawing the structure of this kind of names or IUPAC nomenclature, you have to follow certain rules. It's not like that the rules are very, very important, but you have to follow those rules. See, for example, for drawing this 2-methyl propane, you have to draw the number of carbon, okay, methane, ethane, and third will be the propane. So how many carbons are there in structure? 3 carbons. So just make 1, 2, and 3 carbon. And if you label this as a 1, 2, 3, or even if you label this as a 1, it will be 2. So the middle will be the second. And what is numbering given? 2-methyl. So just on this particular CH3, you have to write the methyl, CH3. Okay, this is a methyl. See, methane and methyl is CH3. C2H6 is ethane and C2H5 is ethyl. Okay. Now, just they have given 2-methyl. So what you have to do, you have to satisfy the valency of this carbon. So it is initially 1. So So how many bonds remain? Three bonds remain. So 1, 2, and 3, and put them as an hydrogen. Hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. Same about this. What is the valency over here? 1. So remaining 3 will be the hydrogen. Hydrogen, hydrogen, and hydrogen. Now for this, see, its valency is like 1, 2, and 3. Only one is remain. So you have to write only one hydrogen. You cannot write 3 hydrogen for this. If you write it, it will be wrong, and that structure will be of no useful. Okay. Similarly, if instead of 2-methylpropane, now if I change the name to like 2-methylpropane, 2-methyl, or instead of propane, now propane we have seen, what I will do, I will write butene, butene. Now see, this is E and E, and in first structure it is A and E, so alkane, alkene, and alkyne. So 2-methylbutene. So what is our rule? Draw the all the carbons which are given. Butene means 4, so I will write 1, 2, 3, and 4 carbons. 2-methyl, so now it's competition, so you can give numbering to this one or this carbon as an 1. So I will prefer this. This will be the 1. So I will give here 1. This will be like a second. So on second, it will be methyl. So it is CH3. And butene. So butene means there is a double bond. So you don't know double bond where. I will prefer to give the double bond over here. You can give double bond anywhere. But you cannot give it here. Why? Or you can give it here. But I prefer to give the butene here, or you can say 2-methyl-4-butene or 1-butene. Okay, if it is a 1-butene, that time there is a numbering. It means you have to, if you are giving 1, 2, 3, 4, that time what you have to do, just remove this double bond from here and you have to put it here, 1-butene. So 1 double bond is there, that's why butene. Now see, methyl is given. Only you have to satisfy the valency of the carbon. Here carbon is there, so one you can put 3 hydrogen, 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 hydrogen. Here valency is 2, so you have to put 2 hydrogen, right? Now what about this? This carbon is already having valency as 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So no need to write any hydrogen on this structure. In the last here, what is the difference? Here, 2 valency is there. So you have to just put 1 and 2 hydrogen over here. So this is the correct structure of 2-methyl-1-butene. Okay, now they will give butyne, they will give propyne, they will give pentyne. So alkane, alkene, alkyne. This is very important in today's lecture also, because in this first topic, physical effects and electronic displacement, we are going to see this type of structures. Okay, so whatever the short notes available to me, as well as this recording of this, will be shared to the sir, and your sir will share this with you. Now in our physical effects and electronic displacement, there are certain bonds are there. As I have told you, bond, these are the bonds. The bond means it is just nothing but the electrons. I think in our in basics of this chemistry, bonds, we have bonds like ionic bond, covalent bond, such type of structures are there. And in this our syllabus, first topic, physical effects and electronic displacement, there are certain type of bonds are there. So first is ionic bond. For example, the H and Cl. See, Cl is electronegative, hydrogen is electropositive, so it will be like a ionic type of bond. But both are giving, like one chlorine is giving electron to here, right? But if you have Cl2, chlorine gas, so it will be having a sharing of electron. So this type of bond is known as a ionic bond. This type of bond is known as a covalent type of bond. So these two types of bonds are there. This type of question can be asked for 1 mark, at least two marks in the given exam. Now there are no limitation for this kind of bonds. Here one electron is shared by hydrogen and one electron is shared by the chlorine. So this is nothing but a bond. Okay, in chloride or in the chlorine is sharing one electron, and other chlorine it is sharing one of the electron. Okay, so this is nothing but a covalent type of bond. This is a ionic type of a bond. I have a PDF for this. I will share you with the example what is the exact definition and what you have to write in the answer of given question. Now very first point here is in the electronic effects, that inductive effect. So let us consider the same structure over here. Again, this type of 2-methylpropane, see what it does. This methyl group is having a enough electrons. Okay, so it will give the electrons, or it will give pull the electrons, and they will be like a giving electron to somewhere. We have a very simple example. This particular structure is known as a ketone, okay, or carbonyl. And if I write both the R groups, CH3 and CH3 both sides, this will be acetone. CH3, C double bond O, CH3. Now see, what I am trying to say you here. Yeah, see, CH3 and CH3, methyl groups are there, and carbonyl group. Okay, see this oxygen, it's an electronegative. If you remember from 11th standard, what is electronegativity? Electronegativity is nothing but it is a capacity to hold the electrons toward itself. It will not give electron to anywhere. So it will hold. Oxygen, it is holding its lone pair and it is pulling electron from carbon. So it is making this carbon as electropositive. So this CH3, they are donating, they are giving electrons to this. This is known as a inductive effect. Okay, so electrons are giving to the adjacent carbon atom. For example, we have the propane CH3, CH2, CH3, right? So this methyl CH3, it is giving electron. This is also giving electron to this. Okay, so this is nothing but inductive. So in inductive effect, when it gives electron like this, we called it as plus I inductive effect, plus I. Okay, so this inductive effect, what is peculiar character of this inductive effect? It is found in generally in the single bond, carbon-carbon single bond. It is generally found in these. There is another type of inductive effect is present, that is known as a minus I. If you remember somewhere, you may have learned the electron donating and electron withdrawing groups. So this comes under the electron donating, they come under the plus I inductive effect, and electron withdrawing, they come under the category of electron or minus I inductive effect. Short note will be asked on this inductive effect. Okay, so the migration or induced movement, dipole movement of these electrons is nothing but we called it as an inductive effect. Now in this is one effect or one example for plus I. What about minus I effect? If now chlorine is there, which is attached to CH2 and CH3, this structure's name is a ethyl chloride, right? How this structure will be prepared? Initially there will be ethane, CH3, one of the hydrogen is removed from this and chlorine is attached. Now see what happened. This chlorine, because of electronegative, this is a electronegative atom, chlorine, so So it will pull the electron, it will keep its lone pair toward itself, as well as it pulls the electron from the CH2 and CH3. So here at this bond, this chlorine is pulling the electron from this, as well as this CH3 is giving electron to this. This type of effect is known as a minus I inductive effect. Okay, so inductive effects are of two types, plus I and minus I type of inductive effect. So there will be a question, you have to write short note on the inductive effect with the suitable example. Alkene, it will show the plus I effect, and some of the electronegative atoms, instead of chlorine, you can attach any type of ether functionality. Okay, OCH3 if it is attached to CH2 and CH3. So this is again pulling the electron. So this type of group are known as electron withdrawing, because it withdraws the electron from this carbon. Now in donation, it is known as a plus I, it is known as electron donating. So it donates the electron to this CH3. Okay, this is a inductive effect. Now the second is like a resonance effect. In the resonance effect, okay, resonance means the electrons which are present in any aromatic type of ring system. So if you have this kind of structure with the double bond, so as I have told you, this single carbon single bond, this bond is known as a sigma bond. But if you have a double bond in alkene, there is a one sigma and one pi bond is there, right? And in C triple bond C, there is a one sigma and two pi bonds are there. Okay, so these pi bonds, these are the pi bond, these are the single sigma bond. This ring is known as a benzene ring. Okay, so before certain period of time, when chemistry is invented, that time all the scientists, they are just thinking that they're all are like open chain type of compounds are present. Okay, there is no any ring type of compounds are present. But after what happened, there is a one chemist, its name is Kekule. He had a daydream while he is in London, and he is traveling through a double decker bus. Okay, so in Pune, if you are from Pune, you can see there are PMT buses are there, but there in the London, there are some double decker, means you can sit on the upper floor or you can sit here only. Okay, so such type of buses are there. And in the afternoon timing, that Kekule, one of the chemists, he's like making a means he's traveling and he fall asleep in the bus. Okay, so during his journey he fall asleep, and in the dream what he saw, that one of the snake is holding his own tail in his mouth. Okay, so that time he saw the dream, and he thought that this structure somewhere somehow, like after methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, hexane, heptane, then octane, nonane, decane, right? After some certain period of time, these will make a ring, and then he invented such a type of a ring system. So this type of structure is known as a benzene, where there are alternate single bond, double bonds are there. Now the resonance means what? As I have told you in the previous structure, these structures are made up of by the electrons here. Electron, 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 electron is there, right? So in the resonance, what happens? The single bond, double bond, okay, or in the conjugation, we can call this as conjugation, double bond, single bond, double bond. What is conjugation? Conjugation means single bond, two double bonds are separated by one single bond. This is the definition for conjugation. What is the definition? Two double bonds are separated by one single bond. This is the example of it. Carbon, carbon double bond. So these two double bonds are separated by single bond. Now, these electrons, they can go from this to this, and this can go further. So this type of drawing structure is known as a conjugation. And if this conjugation comes here in the aromatic system, this is known as a resonance effect. Okay, so if any group, as I have told you, there are certain group, for example, we will go for this only methyl. Okay, one is methyl, and this group is showing plus I effect in case of earlier structure, aromatic, non-aromatic or aliphatic structures. This is giving electron to carbonyl over here. Now see, this CH3 is giving electron to the resonance, or to these electrons are giving electron to the aromatic system. If such type of system is present, then we called it as a resonance. Since it is donating electron, this group is donating electron, this type of effect is known as plus R resonance effect. It is donating electron. I can draw different donation type of group. So all comes under the category of plus R effect. When I attach any electronegative atom to this group, or electron deficient, for example, I will attach now C double bond O and CH3. This group, see, this carbon, this CH3, though this CH3 is giving electron here, but this oxygen, because of oxygen is electronegative, it will hold electron toward itself and it pull the electron from this carbon. So here there is a positive. So ultimately what happened, this being entering, giving electron to the backside, right? So this type of group or effect is known as a minus R type of effect. This whole carbonyl group, this group is pulling electron from the benzene ring. So minus I, which is withdrawing, minus R type of. Here, it is keep donating. Now, if I draw OCH3 over here, see, OCH3. Here, oxygen is having lone pair. So what it does, it gives electron lone pair here. See, there is a double bond. Here valency will increase, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, it's already there. You are making a new double bond, so that's why one of the double bond is breaks and it goes here. Okay, so this type of a revolving of electron in the aromatic system is nothing but the resonance effect. In the conjugated system, such type of a double bond, single bond, double bond, revolving of electrons is known as a plus R or minus R effect. Again, there will be very short question. Write a short note on resonance effect. That time you have to write a statement and you have to write the types of resonance effect, plus R and minus R. I will again give the PDF. I will share the notes for this particular in the group, so you will be better understand. You will also have this type of a, you will have the recording for this video, so you will get the more and more clear idea about this particular section. Now in the second or next third effect is like we in the syllabus it is given hyperconjugation. Okay, so in hyperconjugation, we have if you have ethane, hydrogen, and last is hydrogen. Now, C2H6, so it is an ethane. Okay, if one of this hydrogen, if it is lost from this, what will happen? This carbon is less of one valency. One atom is less. So So I have to put a positive charge over here, right? Positive charge. So if I made a new bond, this positive charge will go from this side. So you know, in the bond there are sharing of two electrons. So one of the electron is giving, one is atom is taking the electron from there. So this type of positive charge can be satisfied by different atoms. Now here, see, there this positive charge carbon, if it is having a positive charge, this type of species is known as carbocation. And in the next topic we have this carbocation. Okay. Sorry. So this can be stabilized by this hyperconjugation effect. If I remove this hydrogen from here, so what I have to do, I have to put double bond over here, hydrogen will lost from this. And what type of structure I will get? Carbon, double bond, carbon, there are two hydrogens, one hydrogen, two hydrogen. And already this carbon is having one and two hydrogen. Now see, this positive charge is removed because this comes and you, what you have, you have subtracted hydrogen. See the valency. Here valence is 4 for this carbon, but it is here 3. But after making this, you have prepared the ethene and see the valency. 1, 2, 3, 4 for this carbon is 4. For this carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. So both the carbon are having same valency. Right? Same valency means 4 valency. So they are satisfied. So this type of effect is known as a hyperconjugation. So how many hyperconjugation effects can be shown by this in this structure? So 3 protons are present, 3 hydrogens are present. So that's why 3 times hyperconjugation is there. Okay, so that's why this effect is also very, very important. And this carbocation can lead to the very good stability. This is the third effect. So out of this 3, 2 questions or 2 short notes can be asked in the question paper. Okay, this is very, very common and general. So last point from this topic, physical effects and electronic displacement is the cleavage of a bond. Now we have such a type of a bond. I will show you this with the help of 2 example again. First is HCl, hydrochloric acid. And another, I want to show you hydrogen, H and H. See, the bond cleavage. Cleavage means breaking of a bond. So this bond, if I want to break, if I break this bond, okay, hydrogen, it will get H plus. This chlorine, it will get HCl minus. So this type of cleavage is known as a heterolysis. Or heterolytic cleavage means what? Hydrogen not taking any electron, but chlorine is taking the electron, and there is a formation of 2 different charges over here. Okay, plus and minus. So this is known as a heterolytic cleavage. But in this case, hydrogen, hydrogen, both are the same. So how many electrons are there? I showed you this hydrogen and this hydrogen. If they are making bond, what they will do, they will give one electron. This hydrogen will give one electron and this hydrogen will give one electron each, right? So both are having one electron. So during the cleavage, this is taking this one, all the electrons. So that's why it is getting a chlorine, is getting a negative charge. Now see, one electron is taken up by this hydrogen and the another electron is taken up by this hydrogen, and this arrow and this arrow, these two arrows are also different. See, this arrow is known as a double headed arrow and it is going on one atom only. Here it is known as a single headed arrow. Okay, so if we have single headed arrow, this is single headed arrow, and double headed arrow that will be having like this. Okay, so if one electron you are migrating, one electron you are transferring, that time you have to use the single headed arrow, and if you are having a two electrons you are taking, that time you are using double headed arrow. What is the species we are creating here? The hydrogen is with the one electron. This hydrogen is with the one electron only. See, one electron will be here, one electron will be here. This type of species are known as a, this type of species are known as a radicals. Okay, in the reactive intermediate topic we have again free radical, so during that time I will focus on this type of radicals. Okay, these are the radical, and this cleavage is a homolytic. Homolytic means same, or like a, it is a homo, means it is taking one, it is taking one. So symmetrical type of cleavage is there. Here unsymmetrical, only chlorine is taking electron, hydrogen is not taking any electron. What is the reason? Chlorine is more electronegative, so chlorine will pull the electron toward itself. That's why such type of a heterolytic cleavage is taking place over here. Here there is a hydrogen, and hydrogen both are the same, so they will take the one electron each. For example, for this tug of war mhanje marathi madhe tyala rassi khech mhantat. If chlorine is having a more and more size, if one of the participant is having more size or more strength, he will pull the all these rope toward himself. In the another example, if both the participant, they are of the same strength and they are having the same size, what they will do? They cannot pull anywhere, so they have, if they pull it further, it might be getting breaking in between the rope. So that's why this is the very famous cleavage, heterolytic, and this is a homolytic cleavage. Okay, so there will be short note, cleavage of bonds, homolytic and heterolytic, such type of question will be asked. You have to give these two examples for homolytic and heterolytic cleavage. So those who have joined late, I will again explain on this first topic, carbon physical effect and electronic displacement, from the beginning. Just pay attention. I will use now Marathi also, so that you will not make any trouble in the understanding. So generally chemistry is divided into three categories: organic, inorganic and physical. We have seen the syllabus. From this syllabus we have started the physical effect of electronic displacement. Here inductive effect is given first. For before going to directly to the effects, I have showed you the point of origin of carbon from the periodic table. Carbon is making a four bonds, so valency of it is four, that's why it is making a four bond. Now if anybody asks you, you should able to draw this atomic orbital structure. Here they are having a configuration like 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, p is having two electrons, so that's why it is having a unpaired electron, it goes here. So that's why this is making a four bond. Why it is making four bond? Because four unpaired electrons are there, that's why they are making a four bond. This is very very common. If you remember this, you will understand the like 50% of organic chemistry. Now it is not that if I told you, मी आता तुम्हाला इथे सांगतोय चार व्हॅलन्सी चारच बॉन्ड करणार आहे, याचा अर्थ लगेच तुम्हाला समजलं आणि तुम्ही ते वापरणार असं नाही. वी ऑल नो दॅट देअर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ कार्बन, कार्बन विथ सिंगल बॉन्ड, कार्बन विथ डबल बॉन्ड अँड कार्बन विथ ट्रिपल बॉन्ड, लाईक CnH2n+2, मिथेन, इथेन, प्रोपेन. सो इफ आय टोल्ड यू ऑर इफ इन द क्वेश्चन पेपर देर इज अ क्वेश्चन लाईक 2-methyl-1-propane ऑर 2-methyl-propane, दॅट टाइम you have to give the methyl CH3 to the second number. Okay, just draw the long chain of carbon. How long? Propane, that means three carbon. So draw three carbon, 1, 2, 3. On 2 second carbon there is a methyl group, so 1 and 2, on 2 there is a CH3. If you put CH3, what is the remaining part? You have to satisfy the valency of this carbon. This carbon is having a valency of 4, so one bond is already made, so just put 3 hydrogen similar to this carbon. Here three bond will be automatically filled. You have to make one new bond and only one hydrogen will make here. Now असं सांगितलं तुम्हाला की तुम्हाला हे समजतं लगेच, पण ज्या वेळेला डबल बॉन्ड अल्किनचं स्ट्रक्चर काढायला सांगितलं जाईल, टू मिथिल वन ब्युटील, सो वन टू थ्री फोर, टू मिथिल, दोन नंबरला इथे मिथिल ग्रुप अटॅच केला आपण, पण इथे केल्यानंतर वन ब्युटीन ई एन ई दिलंय, त्यामुळे डबल बॉन्ड असणार इथे, वन कार्बनला डबल बॉन्ड. नाऊ व्हॅलन्सी विल बी सॅटिस्फाईड, व्हॅलन्सी विल बी सॅटिस्फाईड ओव्हर व्ह्युअर, but in this case there are 1 2 3 and 4 bonds, so that's why there will be no any hydrogen or valency remains, so you cannot have, you don't have to put hydrogen here. If you put hydrogen, its valency will change. See 1 2 3 and 4 and 5 valency, you are making a mistake, so don't put any hydrogen on this carbon, you have to remove the hydrogen. And here also don't attach three hydrogens like this. If you attach two, it will be having a four valence. This is the very basic things. There will be definitely a question on this part. Asa part would tumhala structure nav dile jail, tumhala ase structure draw karava lagel, kiwa vice versa ase structure dile jail, tumhala tyavarna tyacha nav lihayla sangte. This is the first type of question they can ask in this topic. The second point is electronic effects, physical effects and electronic displacement. So in that case we have seen the inductive effect. So in inductive effect, don prakarche inductive effect astat, plus I and minus I effect. Okay, in plus I and minus I effect, what is there? Whenever ja velela electron dile jatat tela mhantat donating. Okay, ani ja vel electron ghetle jatat त्याला म्हणतात विड्रॉईंग, ओढणे. तुम्ही कुठेही मॉलमध्ये गेलात किंवा कुठल्या एखाद्या शॉपमध्ये जर गेला तर पुल अँड पुश असं दोन गोष्टी लिहिलेल्या असत. सो पुल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन अँड पुश ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, दीज आर पुशिंग, पुशिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन टुवर्ड दिस. सो दिस इज प्लस आय, पुलिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन, क्लोरिन इज पुलिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन टुवर्ड इट सेल्फ, सो इट इज मायनस आय इफेक्ट. ओके, next is the resonance. When the ring comes or when the alternate conjugation, alternate double bond single bond is known as a conjugation. Two double bond, if they are separated by one carbon or one single bond, then we called it as a resonance effect or conjugation. And similar, if the pull and push is there, this is a pushing electron in the benzene ring, right? This is a resonance effect. Here in this carbonyl group, it is pulling the electron because of oxygen is electronegative and it is pulling electron over here. So this is minus R, plus and minus R effect. After this, last effect is hyperconjugation, where in this carbon, if it is having a positive charge, I have told you that this type of species is called as a carbocation. Positive charge is carbocation. If it is having a negative charge, we call it as carbanion, iron, carbanion. Cations are positive. This hydrogen, if we remove hydrogen minus H, it will make a double bond and this structure will derive. This will be the stable structure. You will get double bond over here. This is the hyperconjugation. So 1 2 3 hydrogen, you can remove three hydrogen. You remove this first, you will get this structure. Even if you remove this, you will get same structure. Even if you remove this, you will get same, but three times you can do this process. So it's hyperconjugation values like 3. These three effects are there, and these three effects, first is inductive, resonance and hyperconjugation. These three effects will be having a question in your question paper. Write a short note on or explain following effects with the help of suitable example. तीनही इफेक्टवरती एक क्वेश्चन विचारला जाऊ शकतो, त्यापैकी दोन तुम्हाला विचारले जाऊ शकतात, कोणते दोन ते आपल्याला माहिती नाही. तुम्ही तीनही इफेक्ट तयार करायचे या सर्व शॉर्ट नोट्स असतील या तुम्हाला मी शेअर करतो, तुम्ही शेअर केल्यानंतर सरांना करतो, सर तुम्हाला देतील, त्यानंतर तुम्ही त्याचा व्यवस्थित स्टडी करून याचा आन्सर लिहू शकाल. लास्ट पॉइंट फ्रॉम दिस फिजिकल इफेक्ट्स आणि इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिस्प्लेसमेंट टॉपिक इज द लास्ट टॉपिक इज क्लिवेज ऑफ बॉन्ड. सो आय गिव्ह अ विथ द हेल्प ऑफ टू दॅट क्लोरीन इज टेकिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन, हा एकटाच घेतोय, म्हणजेच हा काय झालं हेट्रोलायटिक, सेम नाही झाले, डिफरंट. क्लोरीन निगेटिव्हच्या सेम सेम आहेत, एक एक इलेक्ट्रॉन घेत आहेत वाटून, त्यामुळे याला काय म्हणायचं होमोलायटिक क्लिवेज आणि रॅडिकल तयार होतात. अशा प्रकारे ज्या वेळेला एक इलेक्ट्रॉन घेतो आपण, त्यावेळेला सिंगल हेडेड एकाच टोकाचा बाण सिंगल हेडेड एरो यूज करतो, सिंगल हेडेड एरो आणि डबल हेडेड एरो. अशा प्रकारे हा फर्स्ट टॉपिक आहे. ओके, नाऊ इफ यू हॅव डाऊट इन दिस यू कॅन आस्क मी. आहे तुम्हाला काही यामध्ये डाऊट आहे, समजलं नाही किंवा काही परत सांगायचं असं असेल तर तुम्ही मला विचारू शकता. येस, यास्मिन, ऋषाली, तृप्ती, संतोष, संदीप, मिलिंद, अनिल, इफ यू हॅव डाऊट यू कॅन आस्क मी, किंवा आपण मग पुढे जाऊया. मी तुम्हाला सांगितलं इथे चॅट बॉक्स आहे, तुम्ही इथे क्वेश्चन लिहू शकता किंवा लेक्चर झाल्यानंतर सुद्धा तुम्हाला क्वेश्चन विचारू शकता. नाऊ इफ यू सी द सिलेबस इन दिस सेकंड इज अ लाईक स्ट्रक्चर शेप अँड रिएक्टिव्हिटी ऑफ ऑर्गॅनिक मॉलिक्युल्स. इन दॅट वी आर गोइंग टू सी द व्हेरी सिम्पल अँड व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट न्यूक्लियोफाइल्स अँड इलेक्ट्रोफाइल्स. सो सी हाऊ दिस things are there in the electrophile and nucleophile. These two things we have to turn. Electrophiles are generally showed like this, E with positive charge, and nucleophiles they are shown by the N U, but it is always minus charge. In the question paper they may ask you give the difference between these two, electrophiles and nucleophile, or what is the difference between electrophile and nucleophile. So first thing is that first difference between this is the electrophile, they are always having a plus charge, and nucleophile they are always having a negative charge. So how they are generated, as we have seen in the previous here, if there is an heterolytic cleavage, these are negative charge species is known as a nucleophile, and positive charge species is known as a electrophile. Okay, what is the exact meaning? See, electrophile and nucleophile, we have a atom in which is shown in the first few slides. Okay, so this is the nucleus. Here nucleus is there at the center, and into the shells there are electrons are revolving, as I have showed you this structure over here. This is nucleus and electrons are revolving around it. So here also the same, in the nucleus there is always neutrons and positive charge protons are present. Okay, positive charge is here and here there is a negative charge. So electrophile and nucleophile. Phil, the word phil, phil, electrophilic, phil, electrophile. This phil word, it is having a meaning as an love, love. So electron loving species, electron loving species is known as a electrophile. Okay, this love is same for this nucleophilic, nucleus loving is known as a nucleophile. How simple it is. See, nucleophilic means nucleus loving. So if it is negative charge, you know, if there is a one charge is there, the opposite charge get attracted. Even in the magnet, only the opposite charges they are attracted. So nucleus is positively charged generally. Here positive charge is there, so nucleophile they are having negative charge, so they will not attract to the electrons, there will be repulsion. but this negative charge can go into the nucleus. So that's why these are known as a nucleophilic, nucleus loving. Okay, and this electrophile, these are positively charged, so they can go on this electron, and this positive charge, it can get attracted by the this type of a negative charge. So these species are known as electrophile and nucleophile. But what are the examples? In the examples, if I have already given two example, two kind of example only, CH3, okay, and here OCH3, okay, this CH3, or I can make it as an C double bond O to this. See, if I remove somewhere, because of oxygen, it is always having a positive charge, right? Carbonyl, this carbon is having positive charge. This oxygen is having electron density, so it will having a negative charge. So this species and this species. Now, from your very intermediate or very introductional part in this basics, if you heard about the aldol condensation reaction, there is a example, ketone, and you are making a attack of this OCH3, or see here, this can attack directly over here. So this is what it does, it is directly attacking on this carbon, so nucleus loving. Okay, I will remove this arrow because it will make a confusion. And this nucleophilic means negative charge, now it can attack on this, right? Nucleophilic and electrophilic, if electrons are present, like for example hydrogen, so this can attack on here, and you can make a different structure, right? Nucleophilic and electrophilic. So these two species, very short topic is there, structure, shape and reactivity of organic molecules. Now its reactivity will be depending on what kind of molecules, what kind of atoms, what type of effects are available. You have SN1 and SN2, this type of reactions in the SN1, SN2 type of reaction in the 12th standard. Okay, SN1 and SN2 type of reaction here. In any, if you remember, otherwise you just show, see how after this lecture, what happens? There is a generation of, or there is a such a type of species is there, this chlorine, it will remove, and there will be one of the nucleophile is present. This nucleophile cannot attack from this side, but it goes from the back side. Why? Because this chlorine and nucleophile, they are having a same charge. So that's why they are making a repulsion over here. But it can attack on backside attack. So this is known as a backside attack, and this is the example of SN1 reaction. Okay. Such type of reactions can be found in this case of electrophile and nucleophile. This is in case of nucleophilic substitution, nucleophilic reaction. But see, when there is any type of like electrophilic substitution reaction, you know, the nitration, sulfonation, or even halogenation type of reaction, which are generally taken place on the benzene ring. This is benzene ring. Okay. And if you have chlorine as a electrophile. Now the benzene ring, because of pi bond electrons, they are electron rich species. They can directly attack over here. So this type of reaction gives us a product of chlorobenzene. Double bond, double bond, double bond, and chlorine will come on this species. This is benzene. Now this is chlorobenzene. Okay. This benzene to chlorobenzene is taking place, reaction is taking place of electrophilic attack. So chlorine attacks over here. This is the reaction where a electrophile involved. in this first case is an one reaction, there is a nucleophile type of a reaction involved. Okay, so this is the just correct me if I'm wrong, SN1 and SN2 difference between these two. Just to go through these two type of reactions, SN1 and SN2 reaction. Again, as I have told you, this is very, very important. You have to see for the number of examples which are being asked in the previous question papers also. Now, whenever you are doing any reaction, generally, if you heard about the intermediates, so intermediate means the species which gives us idea about the reaction mechanism. As I have told you, organic chemistry is nothing but about the bonds, carbon, the structures and reactions. So those reactions, because of this type of curly arrows, they are followed certain mechanism, right? They are having a mechanism. These arrows, they are showing some mechanism. But all these mechanisms are like imaginary one. And these mechanisms, they can be proved with the help of certain intermediate. Intermediate means the species which is neither in the starting compound state, neither in the form of a product. That species we can call it as an intermediate. Okay, so here, see, first type of intermediate in our syllabus, reactive intermediate, is carbocation. Second is carbanion, and last is a free radical. So free radical we have just now seen free radical, but I will again explain. Carbocation. What is carbocation? What it does? Carbocation, for example, CH3, this is the species ethane. If you remove one of the hydrogen, loss of one hydrogen, what will happen? CH3 will remain as it is, but this will be like with the hydrogen, and there will be formation of plus charge, right? Because one of the hydrogen is removed. So that's why its valence is not satisfied. This type of species where you are getting positive charge on carbon is known as a carbocation. Okay, one of the hydrogen known as a carbocation. Now, how this forms or how this reaction follows over here, see. This type of species, now if it is having a CH3, I will write as a CH2 and hydrogen. This bond, the electron, if it is heterolytic fission, heterolytic cleavage is there, double-headed arrow. So hydrogen will take electron, so that's why there will be formation of positive charge in the case of carbocation. In case of carbanion, if we have some same species, CH2, hydrogen, I will write like this. Now, this hydrogen, if it is not taking the electron, but it leaves the electron on this carbon, that time what will happen? Again, hydrogen is leaving, but it is not taking electron with himself. So what will we are getting? CH3, CH2, and CH2 will be having a negative charge over here. Okay, see, what is the difference? This case, the hydrogen is taking the electron toward itself. That means carbon will be with the less electron. So it is creating positive charge. But if it is not taking the electron, but it is still leaving, it is known as this negative charge will remain over here only. This type of a species, carbon with negative charge, is known as a carbanion. It is an ion. This is the difference, positive and negative. See, similar example I will again take for free radical. CH3, CH2, hydrogen. Now, two electrons are there, two electrons are taken by hydrogen, we are getting positive charge. Two electrons are there, two electrons are taken by this carbon, but hydrogen is not taking, that's why it is with the negative charge. Now two electrons are there, right? One electron is taken by hydrogen, other electron is taken by the carbon. I have used single headed arrow over here, right? So what will be the structure? CH3 CH2 with one plus this, okay, plus hydrogen, plus hydrogen. Hydrogen is lived in each case. Here, since this is getting a positive charge, hydrogen will get negative charge. This is getting a negative charge, hydrogen will get positive charge. But here in this case, what will happen? This is taking one electron, carbon will get one charge, this will get charge. So this species, positive charge carbocation, negative charge carbanion, one electron is present on carbon, it is known as a free radical. These are the reaction, 1, 2, 3 reactions are involved with the generation of reactive intermediate. In the syllabus, carbocation, carbanion and free radical are the intermediates are there for syllabus. The generation of this is very, very simple. Again, I will explain the help of these three same example. In first, carbon is getting positive charge. How it is getting positive charge? Because this bond is cleaved like this. Ha purna electron yetle ghevun takle, yala kami zale electron manun positive charge yavarti dile. Dusra case madhe kay zale, ya don electrons je ahet ye hydrogen ni ghetles nahi, tya carbon nis ghevun thevle. त्यामुळे त्यावरती काय आला? निगेटिव्ह चार्ज आला. यात त्यांनी काय केलं? म्युच्युअल अंडरस्टँडिंगनी एक तू घे एक मी घे असं केलं आणि त्यामुळे इथे एक चार्ज आणि इथे एक चार्ज तयार झाला. मग यालाच पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज झाला त्याला म्हणायचं कार्बोकटायन, निगेटिव्ह चार्ज झाला त्याला म्हणायचं कार्बॅनियन. आणि कार्बन वरती जर निगेटिव्ह चार्ज पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज या व्यतिरिक्त एकच इलेक्ट्रॉन जरा असेल याला म्हणायचं फ्री रॅडिकल. हे झालं त्याचं जनरेशन. नाऊ द stability, this species, this is a carbocation. If we have one CH3, it will show plus I effect. Okay, now instead of this hydrogen, here there is one CH3, instead of this hydrogen, if there is a CH3, it will give one electron again. If there is a again one more CH3, it will give its electron toward this. So this is plus I effect, right? This is tertiary. If you remember that the trend of stability in the carbocation is tertiary is greater than secondary is greater than primary is greater than CH3. Okay, so this is the trend for the stability in which is increasing in this order. For example, now I will just finish with this carbocation only, then we will see about remaining part. Okay, see, now this trend is like that, but how can come to this conclusion that tertiary is having more and this is having a less? Just a minute to get closed. Okay, see what we got this under this reaction, that CH3 and CH3. So this CH3 is like a C with CH2, one hydrogen, and this is taken, electrons are taken by this, so there is a formation of CH3 and CH2. This will be having a positive charge, right? Now if this hydrogen, two hydrogens are removed, इज इट विजिबल दिसत आहे तुम्हाला ना स्क्रीन वरती की दिसत नाहीये?
दिसत आहे.
ओके हियर सी इफ यू रिमूव दिस हायड्रोजन यू विल गेट टर्शियरी कार्बोकेटायन. टर्शियरी कार्बोकेटायन मीन्स इट इज अटॅच टू द थ्री डिफरंट ग्रुप्स, थ्री सी एस थ्री पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज. इन केस ऑफ सेकंडरी इट विल बी विथ दट ओनली टू सी एस थ्री, सी एस थ्री अँड दिस सी एस थ्री, बट द अदर वन विल बी द हायड्रोजन विथ पॉझिटिव्ह चार्ज. अँड इन केस ऑफ प्रायमरी वॉट इट विल गिव्ह, इट विल गिव्ह द सेम, दिस विल बी लाईक अ प्रायमरी इट ऑलरेडी ड्रॉन. सी रेझोनन्स, रेझोनन्स इफेक्ट जस्ट नाव वी हॅव सीन. This CS3 will give electron, this CS3 will give electron, this CS3 will give. This is third, three degree. We called it as a tertiary. This is giving one and one only, two. So this is secondary. This is give only one. We called it as a primary. So inductive effect is more here. More electrons are given. So more the electron giving, more the inductive effect, and this will be the stable. So that's why tertiary is more stable than secondary, is more stable than primary. This is the trend which easily we can say that okay, this is the trend. Okay, this is important. This you have to okay, this is the trend you have to remember. Otherwise means there will be definitely there will be a question will ask on the either generation or stability. Now the reactions for this carbocation, carbanion and free radicals are not there in our syllabus, only the structure, shape and reactivity is there. Okay, now the during this structure and shape, carbocations, tertiary carbocation, secondary carbanion, they are generally having a like a tetrahedral structures. Okay, and the electronic distribution is there, a very beautiful images are been drawn, like carbon is having a orbitals like this orbital. So I am not good painter, or I cannot draw the good quality of structures over here. Such type of species, such type of structures will be there. I will not go into detail of this type of structure, and I will just share the good quality of colorful structures for this carbocation and carbanion with you. Okay, asha prakare ha topic chota sa ek ahe kyamadhe kay sangitle ki reaction kunti hi hotana kai tari intermediate milto. So intermediate jo asto to intermediate aplyala carbocation asel, carbanion asel, ki free radical asel. मग यामध्ये काय होतं, जनरली जर त्याने इलेक्ट्रॉन घेतले दिले किंवा एक एक इलेक्ट्रॉन जर घेतला, त्यावरनं आपल्याला त्याची वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारांमध्ये आपल्याला त्याचं डिवाइड करता येतं. जसं की मी आत्ता सांगितलं, आपण काय करू शकतो, त्याला कॅटेगराईज करू शकतो टर्शियरी, सेकंडरी अँड प्रायमरी, त्याची स्टॅबिलिटीची ऑर्डर अशा प्रकारची आहे. ओके, जस्ट आय विल सेव्ह इट अगेन. Now see, next is the strength of organic acids and bases, then factor affecting the pKa value, then the aromaticity, benzoid and Hückel soot. So this is like a 100% or very very important topic, because aromaticity, as I already told you the story of that Kekulé, that Kekulé discovered the aromaticity, and he gave the first time aromaticity concept he gave. Okay, so this benzene ring, they are generally showing the aromatic character. What is aromaticity, that I am going to explain in very short to you. See, there is a one scientist, again one chemist, Hückels, his name is Hückels, H U C K E L S, Hückels, his name is Hückels and Hückel. Okay, so in Marathi its meaning is funny, so don't go for this. But just see, Kell is its name, and its rule is given, which is of very, very important. Huckel's. What is that in Huckel's rule or in the aromaticity? The compounds, in the organic compounds, any compound which obey the Huckel rule, the compound which obey the Huckel rule are called, all this type of compounds are called as a aromatic compound. Aromatic compound. What is the aromatic compound that we have to learn first? Aromatic compound, so it should be planar. It should be planar. It should be conjugated. It should be conjugated. And last thing, it should be cyclic. Three things are given. Aromatic type of compounds, they should have this type of planar, conjugated and cyclic system. Then only we can go for the Huckel's rule. Okay. If any system is planar, planar means all the atoms present here are one should be in one plane. For example, right now this lecture you are watching on your mobile or on laptop. So that is in one plane only. It's not like that something is coming up inside, going below or backside of the your mobile, something coming out of the mobile, right? It is in one plane. So those systems are planar. I already explained this conjugated. What is conjugated? Double bond, two double bonds, if they are separated by one single bond, these type of bonds are known as a conjugated. And cyclic, cyclic means they should be in the form one cycle. All the atoms should form one cycle. Should be cyclic. Now, Huckel, what he gave? He gave a rule that any system which is obeys this type of rule or this type of condition, planar, conjugated, cyclic, and 4n plus 2 pi electron system, those systems are called as aromatic. Okay, planar paije, conjugated paije, cyclic paije, ani tyane 4n plus 2 pi electron system cha rule jar obey kela tar apan yala kay mhanu shakto, Huckel's rule to obey karto, ani to kay, this is Huckel's rule, this compound said to be aromatic. We'll go one by one. Planar, I will explain. Conjugated, I have also explained. Cyclic means the ring type of compound. Now, what about 4n plus 2? This n here is nothing but the number of integer. If you put 0, if you put the value of 0, this whole will become 0. Your answer will come as n. If it is 0, then it will be like a 2 pi. Right? If it is 1, your answer will be C, 1. 4 ones of 4 plus 2, 6. So 6 pi. If it's 2, 2 fourths are 8 plus 2, 10. If it is 2, it will be like a 10 pi electron. If it is 3, it will be like a 3 fourths are 12 plus 2, 14 pi electron. So if you found out here the difference of 4, 4 here, the difference is 4, 4, 4 and continue. You can find out any number of integer put here in this formula. You can find out the electrons present. This pi, I have told you that double bonds are there. That means pi electron. So here, if you put the value as one of the integer, you will get 6 pi. How many pi electrons are here? I have told you that single bond, sigma bond, pi, double bond. So one bond is made up of 2 electrons. So here, 2 pi electrons, here 2 pi electrons are there, here 2 pi electrons are there. How many electrons are there? Total 6 electrons. Yes, 6 is the in this series, that's why this system is said to be aromatic one. This system is obeying the Huckel's rule. It is a planar, it is present in one plane. It is conjugated, no doubt. Double bond, single bond, double bond. It is conjugated and it is cyclic. It is made up of one of the cycle. So it is also being 4n plus 2. So 6 pi electrons are there. This is the aromatic system. Okay, so this type of structures which obeys this type of rule is known as a aromatic type of compounds, and they are obeying the this type of rule. Okay, now in your question paper they will give you the question, what is aromaticity? Okay, what is aromaticity? You have to write its definition. The compound which are obeying the planar conjugated cyclic and 4 plus 2 pi electron system, this is Hückel's rule, obeys Hückel's rule, are said to be aromatic. For understanding aromatic, you should know the anti-aromatic type of system. For example, see, I will draw one more example. Okay, this system is planar, this system is conjugated, this system is cyclic. But if I put the value 0, I will get 2 pi. If I put the value as 1, I will get 6 pi. How many pi electrons are here? 2 pi from this, 2 pi from this. Total 4 pi. 4 pi system. So this is not aromatic. Why? It is not obeying the Hückel's rule. Okay. 4 pi. In multiple of 4, 8, again for 12, the number which you have left over here is between this 4, 8, 12, then 16, all are known as anti-aromatic, okay? Anti-aromatic type of rules, anti-aromatic system. Its rule, what type of rule they are obeying? Planar, conjugated, cyclic, and they are obeying 4n pi system, 4n pi. 4n pi. If you put 0, it will be totally become 0. If you put 1, it will be 4. If you put 2, 8. If you put 3, 12 pi, and so on in the multiple of 4. This is anti-aromatic. This is aromatic type of system. They will give you the structure. You have to count the electron. You have to find all these possible structure. Okay. This type of structures are very, very important. They may give you the directly straightforward question. What is Hückel's rule? What is aromaticity? Or they can give you the structure. You have to find the total number of electrons. You have to find whether it is aromatic, anti-aromatic type of system. Now, the benzonoid. Benzonoid means the structure which are having the benzene in it. Such type of structures are also given. Okay. This is the strength of organic acids and bases. Okay, this type topic is there. She is of very, very much importance. Aromaticity type of compound, Hückel's rule. This is one of the important topic. Now, last thing that we are going to see is about the stereochemistry. So the stereochemistry, it's very, very vast. I already have the PDF of like 66 small pages. Today itself you will get that PDF from your sir. I will show you that PDF also if it is okay, it's not downloaded yet. Just give me one second. I will show you that PDF right now because it's of very, very it is a important, no doubt. Those who are listening this lecture, whether it is useful, samajhte ga tumhala? नहीं समझते है, खूब फास्ट होता है, स्लो होता है,
समझते छान.
And you will have the recording as well as I will give you the all the PDF. Don't worry about that. Okay. I'll just see the this is the PPT. I will share the screen again. Okay, so see, this is the PDF, stereochemistry. I'm going to explain you, but I will just want to show this of 66 slides are there. The definition of stereochemistry is given. What are stereoisomer, enantiomer, distereomer, a symmetrical center. This is the chirality with the help of beautiful example. Chairs are given, different examples are given. Okay, example of chiral center, see. Chiral plane of symmetry. What is plane of symmetry? The cis compound, trans compound, R and S configuration, E and Z. This is like a very good type of PDF. It is up in PDF and I will give it to you today only. See, plane polarized light. I think in 11th or 12th, something like this. Dextrorotatory and levorotatory light is there, specific rotation. Some problems are also given. Biological activity of those compounds. So this is a very important topic and I will share this as soon as possible with you. Now, what I want to complete or what I want to explain to you here is, see, now most important part. About E and Z type of configuration. E and Z, what is E and Z that I am going to show you? Also, I have this different PDFs and I will show you. Now see, for is it visible, this PDF PowerPoint, this slide? Colored one, is it visible? This thing,
yes, sir. Yes, this.
Okay, so see, now E and Z and cis and trans, that is very important. What is cis and trans and what is E and Z? Now, just we have seen the structures, alkene, if alkene is there, okay, and alkene is having two bonds, two groups attached to it. Now, hydrogen, CH3 and CH3. If such a structure is there, and I will draw the same structure again. Carbon, double bond carbon, hydrogen, then CH3 on top and this CH3 at the bottom. What is the difference? See, you know the meaning of same side and opposite side. Okay, this carbon is of alkene, this carbon is of also alkene. So if you put an imaginary arrow or imaginary plane over here, see, this like this plane. Okay, now what happened? This side is, you can say, this is up side, this is the bottom side. These hydrogens are both on the same side, right? These are same side. These CH3s are on same side. So if the groups, similar groups are present on the same side, this type of system is known as ciscoid or cis. Cis means in the some Latin language, I think in Latin language, cis, this word is stand for the same side. Okay. And if, see the plane, again, this plane, CH3 and CH3, they are opposite side of this plane, right? And hydrogen and hydrogen is also opposite side. In the Greek language, this word opposite is also called as a trans. Cis and trans. So these two are there. Now, it's like a mathematics. If the question is asked, they will give the structures, like these two structures, and what you have to write, only these three small letters you have to write, cis or trans, T-R-A-N-S, trans or C-I-S. See the spelling, C-I-S, and it is not S-I-S, like so many times I have seen these students, they are making some silly mistake. For our sister, we are using like SIS, SIS. This is not SIS, huh? This is SIS, siscoid. This is the word, is actual word is siscoid type of system. And it is, its meaning is on same side. What they will give, they will give you the structure. What will be the question? Question like will be like this. Question number one. Predict or cis or trans. Whether given system is cis or trans. Asha prakare question vichatla jail. Ani direct eka sathi itka shabd lihayla kiti mark astil aplyala. Ha question asel 4 markanna jar don structure astil tar. फक्त इतकाच शब्द लिहायचा 2 मार्क. मग तुम्ही जर बरोबर लिहिलं तर याला 2 मार्क मिळतील. आणि यामध्ये काहीतरी केमिस्ट्री आहे का, तुम्हाला सेम म्हणजे काय आणि अपोजिट म्हणजे काय एवढं समजलं पाहिजे. सो हायड्रोजन अँड हायड्रोजन आर द सेम, सो दे आर प्रेझेंट ऑन द सेम साइड ऑफ दिस प्लेन. नाव द प्लेन विल बी लाईक, दिस इज नॉट द एव्हरी टाइम इट मे बी लाईक हॉरिझॉन्टल, इट मे बी व्हर्टिकल. नाव व्हॉट दे विल डू, they will draw such type of a plane, okay, and what they will give, they will draw the alkene, carbon double bond carbon. Now instead of this they will give CH3, they will give OH, here there will be OH. What will be this, whether this is cis or trans? This will be like CH3, opposite CH3 and CH3 opposite. Yeah. And OH and OH are opposite. Very good. The opposite means it will be trans. So this is also trans, this is also trans. So again, what I will do, if you are requesting, I will give you the number of examples for this cis and trans. Okay. And you have to just label it. You can check it from me. I will give the answers, cis and trans. It will be very, very easy for you. Now, cis and trans is okay. Now, based on same, only you have to remember one thing. For cis, there is a new word, Z is given. And for trans, E is given. So you have to remember this. Cis is Z, trans is E. In our question paper, they will ask cis and trans for 4 marks. And they will again ask whether the given structure configuration E or Z, E and Z or E or Z. Okay, for that I will draw new structure over here. Carbon, double bond carbon, OH, OH, H and H. Cis and trans, now you understand that OH are present on the same side, so this is a cis. Okay, this is cis, no doubt. But I have told you that cis is also known as a Z, and trans is also known as E. In our syllabus, they may not ask cis and trans, they will ask E and Z. So if it is a cis, you have to write only Z over here. This will be like writing one alphabet, it will be like of 2 marks. So getting pass in this subject is very, very easy. Okay, only E or Z you have to write. So now I will draw one structure, you tell me whether it is E or Z. It will be not that much difficult. I will write chlorine, I will write H. So whether it is E or Z,
Z.
This is a J. Very good. Just read the question, whether what they are expecting from you, E or Z or cis or trans. Similarly, write it. If they have asked you for cis and trans, and if you write Z or E, they will not give you the correct, they will give 0 marks, right? This is very simple, but you have to read, right? You have to just read the question carefully and then accordingly answer this. Now, there are no any rule, there are nothing. Only writing one alphabet, it will give the 100% or just now you are familiar with this, you are giving very good answers. That means I think this is very, very simple and you will get definitely out of marks for this question. Now in the question paper, there is again for writing R or yes, you will get again 100% marks. What will be the question? Whether R or S configuration is present in given structure, R or S. So just now I think I have showed you this PDF. Here there is a optical activity in 11th and 12th standard. It is also there, polarimeter they are placing, light is there. Okay, that light monochromator, only single light goes here and this polarizing filter is there. Now see the sample, this is a sample cell, sample is placed over here. Here light falls on it. The light, if it goes on this side or this side, eye is on this side, means you are watching it from this. This is placed in like a polarimeter, one of the machine. If you watch it by rotating on this side or this side, what is this side? This side means if it is going on right side, it is known as a dextrorotatory. If it is rotating left side, we called it as a Leo rotatory. Dextrorotatory means clockwise and Leo rotatory means anti-clockwise. D and L, capital D, capital L, polarimeter, clockwise and anti-clockwise. Now, how it comes in predicting the R and S configuration? See, there is a chirality. One concept is there, chirality, chiral compound. Chiral compound, this definition is there for one mark. Chiral compound means the compound which is having four. What is the valency for carbon? Carbon's valency is four, right? So the four valency means how many groups are attached? Four groups are attached. This will be like a chlorine. Yeah. So I'll write chlorine again. It's not working that way. Okay, see, this will be carbon, this carbon will have four bonds, one is hydrogen, other is CH3, I'll make this hydrogen as a C2H5. Then I'll CH3, then I'll make it OH, and I'll make NH2. So everything will be solved in this question. All the groups, all four groups are different. This carbon, this compound is known as chiral. CHIRAL. This is chiral compound. Okay. What is chiral compound? Chiral compound means all the four groups attached are different. This is a very simple definition. Chiral compounds or this carbon is also known as asymmetric. Asymmetric, not symmetrical. Asymmetric, okay? Symmetric and asymmetric. Two compounds are symmetric, means all two may be same. But now both are, all four carbons or groups are different, which called it as an asymmetric or chiral. Both are the same. Okay. If it is not having two groups same, these two groups are same, then it is achiral and symmetric. But now four are different, we called it as a chiral carbon or a symmetrical carbon. Understand, this is very simple. Now, this compound, if I put in the given system, polarimeter, if I put it here in the sample cell, it will deflect this light here and there. Okay. If the rotation is clockwise, I will call it as an, if it is clockwise, clockwise R and anti-clockwise. Anti means opposite to clock. Then I will write it as an yes. Now what will be the question? Predict whether it is R or yes. Okay. For R and yes, how to predict this? For R and yes, you have to give the what you have to do, you have to find out whether it is clockwise or anti-clockwise. Now for clockwise and anti-clockwise, what you have to do, you have to put it into the machine, but you don't have machine. Or in your question, in your exam, they will not give you to the directly that machine. So you have to use certain rules, okay? And these rules are given in our book. What are the rules? Very simple rule is that you have to find the atomic number of these four groups which are attached to this particular carbon. Where, from where we are getting atomic number? So again, we have to go into the periodic table, okay? As I have told you, there are so many funny tricks are there for remembering this. So carbon, how many groups are there? First, I will just label the carbon. See, carbon, carbon, oxygen and nitrogen, NH2, nitrogen. How many groups are there? Three. So carbon is there, nitrogen is there, oxygen is there. Oxygen is having highest atomic number, nitrogen and then carbon. Okay. So just now we open it. This particular group, I will just go for the periodic table. How to remember this? So this is Helena ki Rab se Faryad. Okay, you can write it in Hindi. You will understand. Here, beta mange car centro, bap roye. Okay, again that is the tricks given here. In Marathi, this group, P block, Pal Gangadhar Indian Tilak. Okay, Gangadhar Tilak, so Pal Gangadhar Indian Tilak. This carbon silicon group, carbon group C, Kashila Gele Shankar Parvati. So you can remember all these atoms, Kashila Gele Shankar Parvati. Now we are from all from Marathi medium. I don't find any difficulty to remember this type of statement for remembering the whole periodic table. Okay. Nahi pyare aisa sab. Okay. Nahi pyare aisa sab bhartiya. So this type of Marathi, you can just call any type of atom. And I will recommend you to use the YouTube for this. Find out the tricks. All these elements can see this. Lal Shiryacha Prasad Nandune, Prime Minister Srimati Indira Gandhicha table aur dila hota. Okay, so these are the F block. F block is very, very difficult to keep in mind or to remember all these elements, but still you can remember if you remember this type of a trick. And all these tricks are available free of cost on the YouTube. So just try to make an effort, search it on YouTube, you will find the different tricks. Now, about clockwise and anti-clockwise, what I have told you, how many elements you have to remember? 10 elements. First is hydrogen, after that helium, okay, then there is somewhere carbon is there, nitrogen is there, oxygen is there, okay. So here, 6, 7, 8. So what is my rule? The highest atomic number, it will come first. So here, carbon, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen. So OH group will be having highest priority, right? It will get first priority. Second, nitrogen. Nitrogen is having second priority here. So I will give nitrogen. Now here, carbon, carbon having 6 same. But here two carbons are there, right? C2H5, two carbons, here only one carbon. So just give the labeling or the priority to C2H5 first, then CH3. Now you have to write R or S, clockwise, anti-clockwise. Now, if what I have a watch, everybody has a watch at their homes, wall watch, okay? Watch how the watch is there in our home. See, the wall is having a circular watch. Here there is a 12, here there is a 3, at the bottom there is a 6, on the left hand side there is a 9, right? And 12 is there.
Anti-clockwise, yes na?
Yeah, very good. I'll just find it out for others. If it is yes, we will correct it. Okay. See, this is a watch. Aaple ghari asa ghadyaal aahe. Now, if imagine if I just lift this structure from here and if I put it here, what will happen? See, OH is having first priority, NH2 second priority, C2H5 third priority, and CH4 is fourth priority. So how I am going from 1 to 4? That is the trick. See, 1, I have to follow this path, 1, 2, and 3, right? But our clock is following such direction, 12 ke baad 3, 3 ke baad 6, then 9. So this is clockwise. But now I am following the wrong path. I am going from 9 to 6. So this is anti-clockwise, right? If I am going anti-clockwise, that means what will be my answer? My answer will be yes. So this structure is having the answer yes. Is it clear? R or yes? Samajhte ka?
Yes, sir.
So this is yes. Fakta yes lila, you will get 2 marks out of 2 marks. Initially also, if you have written 2, E or Z, cis or trans, you are getting 2 marks. Similarly, now I will give you the very small structure. Just tell me whether it is having R or yes configuration. Okay, I will write chlorine here, hydrogen here, CH3 here, and I will attach OH here. Tell me, or instead of doing this, what I will do, I will write just wait, chlorine, hydrogen here, OH here, and H here. Now tell me.
Clockwise R, na?
What will be the first priority group here?
OH.
OH. How come OH? OH will not come as first. See, that's why I'm telling you, you have to remember the periodic table. If the periodic table is visible to you, see, chlorine, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen. Oxygen is having atomic number 8. But where is chlorine? Chlorine is present here. Chlorine's atomic number is 17. Right? So 17 in number is more, atomic number is more than oxygen, right? So that's why we have to give the first priority to the chlorine. Now tell me, whether it is R or S, this will be first, this will be second,
yes, yes.
Third, this will be fourth. Again, I am following the anti-clockwise.
Anti-clock.
So this will be the yes. Is it simple?
Yes, sir.
Okay, here, how to remember, when we are labeling 1, that means it is a first priority group. 1, first priority group. 4th, it is a lowest priority group. Okay, similarly, here hydrogen is lowest priority group. It is present on vertical axis, vertical bond. Lowest priority CH3, it is on vertical. Hydrogen, it is again vertical. But now, see, if I have such a structure, carbon, hydrogen, then there is a chlorine, here is a CH3 and OH. Now tell me, see, chlorine is 1, OH is 2, CH3 is 3, and this hydrogen is 4. Now I have to go to from 1 to 2, 1 to 2, then 3. And if I go further, then I will reach to 4. Okay. So it is a clockwise, right? So what will be the next answer? Its answer should be clockwise means R. But there is only one rule is there. What is that rule? The lowest priority group, fourth priority group, or lowest priority group, if it is present on horizontal axis, then R is changing to S. This is only one rule. Okay, if lowest priority group, if it is present on horizontal axis, every time, even if it is R, you have to change it to S. If it is yes, you have to change into R. And in the exam, in your answer sheet, you can write R changing to yes, or simply you can write the answer as an yes for this. समजलं का? एकमेव रूल इथे आहे, जर लोवेस्ट प्रायोरिटी ग्रुप, लोवेस्ट प्रायोरिटी म्हणजे चौथा प्रायोरिटीचा ग्रुप हा इथे जो लोवेस्ट प्रायोरिटी ग्रुप आला हा जर हॉरिझॉन्टल एक्सिस वरती असेल तर काय करायचं, आर च यस आणि यस च आर करायचं. समजलं का? नाउ इनॅन्शिओमर्स, इन दिस सेम पीडीएफ इनॅन्शिओमर्स आर एक्सप्लेन. It's very, very simple. See, enantiomer means mirror images of each other. Okay. See, enantiomer. Stereoisomer that are non-superimposable mirror images of each other. For example, our hand. See, this hand, this is a left hand, right? Our left hand is having a mirror image. This is a mirror, right? And if I put this, if I lift it and if I put it here, see, thumb is on right side here, thumb is on left side. So I cannot superimpose, right? I cannot superimpose. Superimpose means you cannot put one another on the another, right? For example, then may I have given example here. If it is not, I will write it here. See, now. Mirror, I will draw one mirror. This is a mirror. This is the structure. Hydrogen. Hydrogen. CH3. Here. C2H5. Okay. And here it is OH. What is the mirror image of this? I have to write here OH. So the hydrogen will come in the mirror close CH3 and C2H5. So these are the mirror images of each other. But if I lift this, if I me he uchlun jari avar thevla tar kay hoil, hydrogen will come on this side, right? So they are not superimposed with each other. For example, I have a square and its mirror image is square only, right? If I lift this and if I put it here, it will superimpose to all the end, right? So that type of this is not, we call it as the same. This in this is the same, right? But these two, for example, again, if in front of mirror, if I put now cyclopropane, its image will be like this, right? And if I lift this and if I keep on this, I will get something like this. So this will not superimpose. And if non-superimposable mirror images are there, those are known as enantiomers. Okay, enantiomers are non-superimposable mirror images of each other. Okay, enantiomer. What is the example? Our pair of hand. This pair of hand or the mirror image of your hand. It will not superimpose. Okay, so this is the, I will just stop sharing and I will show you exact meaning of this. What is the mirror images actually? Okay, just tell me whether okay, am I visible to you? Disturb me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes.
See, this is my hand and this is my hand. Okay, so if I put mirror over here, I will get the this as a mirror image. This is a mirror image. Now if I lift this and if I put it, it will not be superimposed because my thumb is here on one image and other thumb is here, not superimposed. So these are called as a enantiomers. But now if the image of this is like this, in here I put it and if I superimpose, this will be like a same, right? This is superimposed. Each finger is superimposing with each other. So that's why this is an example of same image. So this is called as a same, but this is a enantiomer, which are not yet superimposed with each other. So this much part is there in the syllabus for stereochemistry. The sum of this conformations of ethane, butane, then I think cyclohexane is also there, and drawing a wedge shape structures. For example, I think sawhorse type of structure, Fischer type of structure, those are also included in our syllabus. In the syllabus also, many books are also given. So if you are having this type of this type of structures are generally being called as a Fischer type of formula. Okay, Fischer type of formula. And wedge, wedge means wedge, wedge, wedge means bhala. Marathi mein tyala bhala mantat. Bhala means such type of bonds are there. Okay, this is a tar, and we can also show the images or the bonds with their dotted arrow or wedge shape arrow. These are nothing but the sawhorse type of wedge projection, sawhorse projection. Some of the structure, they are written in this type of circle fashion. We can write this inside out, this type of structure. These structures are known as a Newman projection. So this kind of stereochemistry is there in our syllabus. Now, again and again, I am repeating,